Hello, everyone. Resident Evil 7's out, and we all know what this is by now. The latest Resident Evil game, taking a very different style than the previous games, and some people are interested in that. Other people disappointed that this game is moving away from the shooter style that it had embraced in Resident Evils 4, 5, and 6. But I'm interested in seeing how this new style turned out, this slower first-person, more of an emphasis on maybe horrors, and maybe jump scares, maybe, could be, from what we played of the demo. Of course, this game has had a long-running demo that's had a couple of updates by now. A playable teaser, if you will. So we're going to start this. We're going to play through Resident Evil 7, because why not? I was going to play it anyway. So I guess let's all join in on this together. And it'll be very scary, I'm sure. Lots of things to be frightened of. It's title screen with its minimalism, its black background, is giving me the spooks already. And we'll see if that just increases as we bumble our way through RE7. I don't know how long this game is. Resident Evil games tend not to be that long. But, of course, this game is a different style than we've seen before, so it might be that everything that I know about Resident Evil maybe just gets thrown out the window. We're going to start the game, see what happens. On easy, they're going to take it easy on us. But on normal, it's just your average difficulty. Well, I figure that part of a game being scary is probably going to be the threat of being killed by monsters. And if it's easy, I guess that kind of takes away from the potential of being frightened. And I usually would play Resident Evil games on normal anyway. If they had a difficult, I'm trying to think about that. RE1 didn't really have a difficulty, did it? It had Jill and Chris, and Jill was sort of the easier mode, but didn't have an official difficulty. In any case, I feel like playing on normal, so I think that's what we're going to do.
Hey, baby! I just wanted to send a quick hello, and I love you. Oh, good news. I'm going to be coming home soon. Yay! Oh, I cannot wait to be done with this babysitting job and come home to my loving husband. I miss you. Oh, I gotta get back to work. I love you, Ethan. I miss you so much. I'm sending tons of kisses. Bye, baby.
Ethan, you were right. I did lie to you. I shouldn't have. All I can say is that if you get this, stay away.
Hey, it's Ethan.
Oh, hey. You all right? You just disappeared the other night.
Yeah, no, I'm good. I'm good. It's Mia. She's not dead, she's alive. She's back.
They found her? How? What happened?
I don't know. Look, I don't know how, but she's back. She's back somehow. Maybe it's a prank, but she wants me to come and get her.
Where is she?
Dolvie, Louisiana.
I know,
but what if it is her? I have to find out what happened.
And it looks like we're in control. I mean, we really shouldn't drive looking away from the road, but we have some experience with that. Oh, it's forcing me back. knowing that it's dangerous just to not look at the road. Even though I can look around, I don't have control of my body. Control of my head, but not my body. And you might have heard what the intro story was right there. We have a wife.
This is the place.
Who was thought to be dead. But she sent us a message saying that she's waiting for us in our special place. She didn't say that. And the achievement says that she's alive. But, I mean, we know we've played games like that before, right? We could walk back. No, we cannot walk back the way we came. We're going to walk into this small town. It's not really a town. It seems too small to be a town. Because we got a message from our dead wife saying that we should come. And we came alone by ourselves. Wait, the video we just saw, she said in her message to Ethan, she said, if you get this message, don't come. Why did she send Ethan the message? That seems... And Ethan didn't mention anything about that. Wait, did Ethan get the video, I wonder? Or maybe it was something else that he got. Because from his reaction, it did not seem like he saw the video in which she was in distress and said, don't come. We have to find Mia. That's the objective. I have a feeling we're not going to do that anytime soon. So yeah, I think maybe whatever information Ethan saw, it was probably not what we saw right there at the beginning. There's a road going down there. And a house. Up here. But can we go through this gate? No. It's a chain on it. Well, we might as well go down this path. We don't get any background information right off the bat. We only know we're Ethan. Our wife, our dead wife, is Mia. Our dead wife, who is maybe not dead, but somewhere in this very welcoming looking place. It's a very welcoming looking place. We have come here on our own to look for her. I'm sure we have our reasons, good reasons, that we came alone. Sewer gators, let's see. Sneak into a Louisiana ghost house. All right, so we played the demo. And I guess that's them. Those are the people from the demo who were recording like a Ghost Hunters type of show. And they got killed in the house. So I guess this is their van. The demo giving a little bit of background on what this is about. Don't know how important those characters might end up being if they're going to come back in the game proper. But I guess we'll find out. In the demo, of course, we were assaulted by a large southern man who welcomed us to the family. Oh, hey, is that him? That might be Family Guy. Family Man, I should say. Family Guy is something completely different, and I would not want to see any of those characters in this game. I mean, let's be stealthy, because if there's one thing we know about this guy is that he likes to punch us in the face. Fancy. What is this made of? Maybe deer. It's kind of hard to tell. Maybe a bull's skull. Not sure. It looks like we have to go through that, because of course we do. Anything over here? Ah, birds. The birds that got me. To be fair, crows do have a history of being dangerous in Resident Evil. And we don't have any weapons to defend ourselves now, if it turned out that those crows are full of virus and want to kill us. In the last version of the demo, we did get a weapon. So there should be ways to defend ourselves in this game. There should be combat. Don't know how much combat there's going to be. if there's going to be more than the demo might have led us to believe. Is that all? We got a driver's license. I'll check our inventory. Okay. What's this? Email from Mia. The printout of the email from her wife, Mia. Aha! Says the achievement. Did we discover something? I mean, I guess it's because we got Mia's driver's license. So it indicates that she's here. And someone was trying to burn it with a strange black substance. Can we look at it more in... Like, hold on. No, not that. Can we, like, get a closer look at it? Yeah. There we go. And what about this? Nope. Let's see. All right, we have... It says it's a printout of an email. We can hit F. Let's see. July 18th, 2017. Dilvey, Louisiana, Baker Farm, come get me. That was not the video message we saw at the beginning. She said don't come in the beginning, so I don't know what this is. Also, I know I'm taking my time, but, you know, I just like to think, I just like to savor things, think things through. If he thought his wife was dead, and this was the extent of what he got, he's really buying that? He's really coming by himself to this place? If I thought my wife was dead, it would take a hell of a lot more than this to make me think, wait, maybe she's not. Maybe she's not. I don't know. Oh, this looks familiar. Yeah. This is the entrance to the house from the demo. Yep, we can swing that, just like the demo. And this is where the film crew entered the house. Anything we can interact with here? Just checking. All right, let's see if the layout of this place is the same as it was in the demo. It's quite dark. Okay. You know, it's quite dark, and the funny thing is that this, the brightness settings are not as dark as the game recommended. I never bring it down to what the game recommends, because that's usually too dark, especially if you're recording for video. But right now, this blackness seems pretty dark. I don't see a reason that I would have needed to turn this down anymore. Was that Family Guy? Family Man, I'm sorry. I don't want to associate him with anything else. I can't use anything here to cut that open. Maybe later. Layout of the house is the same so far. Is there an axe in here? There is not. What's this? Can I take it? Doesn't seem like it. That is locked. Doesn't seem like I can take the picture, though. I can't really tell what the picture is of, either. Yeah. You're just being a good citizen by turning off the water, or whatever that black sludge was, when you see it running. Yep. I remember that. Lean in and give it a good whiff. Is the crow still in this? It is. Is the refrigerator still disgusting? Yep, it sure is. I mean, just because you're virus-infected monsters doesn't mean you have to let things get this bad. I guess I've never been a virus-infected monster, so I can't judge. What's this? Over 20 missing in 2 years. Ooh, ghosts sighted in Bayou. There was a ghost girl in the demo, and people were wondering, you know, Resident Evil usually is sort of about science gone wrong, so what does a ghost have to do with this? Nothing else I can do with this, I guess. Maybe we'll find out what a ghost might have to do with the world of Resident Evil. Yeah, this door's blocked. And we could go up up here. But if this is like the demo, then this switch might not be working yet. No. I guess we need to find the fuse. Ah, so instead of typewriters, we have cassette recorders. It's sufficiently archaic. All right, I guess we need to find a VCR. And I didn't seem to need to use an item to save my game, so I was wondering when I saw this, am I going to have to find cassettes to use to save, like the ink ribbons? But doesn't really look like it. Did not seem like I had to use an item. Nothing. This is where the finger was in the demo, I think. Doesn't seem like anything's different so far, really. Might be Mia, hard to say. Those stacks of mail, no, stacks of newspapers, I guess. And there's a guy and someone lying on a bed, I guess. Let's see. Yeah, that fuse is missing. I don't have a fuse, can't use it. But the TV and VCR are over there, so I guess we're going to get to use this thing. Can I play the piano now? Could not in the demo. Nope, that just happens again. What's this? Yeah, it's a door. Oh, this is new. We couldn't examine this. Looks like the owner's. Yep, that looks like a man that has punched us in the face before. What about down here? Yep, can I... It looks like I... Oh, no. Okay, here. Like, it is there. For a second, I was thinking the game was not acknowledging that I could see that switch. Fuse is not here. Oh, a ladder. Can we actually go down this time? Seems so. Am I not going to be able to go back up? Maybe I should have watched that tape before I did that.
Damn it.
Yeah. Looks like I might have lost my opportunity to watch that tape right now. Hopefully we'll get another opportunity. Wanted to see if I could duck in the water. It does not look like it. I wonder at what point does Ethan start to think that maybe this wasn't a good idea? Because I'm figuring maybe that point has happened by now. Or maybe he hasn't quite gotten it quite yet. That's probably the point where Ethan starts to think that maybe this was not a good idea. I'm gonna guess that's it right there. does not look like I can actually interact with those or these other posters right here. House is deceptively large. You wouldn't think it would have all this looking at it from the outside. What does this say? I'm sorry, Daddy. I'm not sure anymore. Sorry, Daddy. I will not be... Oh, and I will not be bad anymore. I'm sorry, Daddy. Okay. So it just says that over and over. Yep, that's what you use a toilet for. You ever see a toilet that's not full of syringes? Well, it's not being used properly.
Mia?
What? I mean, yeah, there is someone in there. We do not have anything that we could use to break that. Let's see. Ben, dead. Harold, turn. Arthur, turn. Tamara, turn. Craig, dead. Leela, dead. Sean, dead. William, dead. Travis, turned. Peter, dead. Andre, dead. Not Andre. Clancy. Okay, so Andre and Clancy, they were from the film crew in the demo. Clancy is L? There's more. Everyone's either turned or dead. The only exception is Clancy. Clancy was the guy that we were playing as, the cameraman from the VHS tape in the demo. He's the only one who's not turned or dead. He is L. Oh, bolt cutters. We need these. I wonder if we're going to meet Clancy somewhere in this house. I guess I could go back there and cut that chain. I feel like I want to explore a bit more before I do the thing that's going to advance the story. Anything round that I should look at, that I should pick up? Doesn't seem like it. All right. Let's cut that chain. And, see if that's actually our wife. Are we going to find her this early in the game? Let's do it. There we go. Keep forgetting which button to push. Rather, which key to press, since this is the PC version and I'm playing with a keyboard and mouse. All right. Just going to turn right over. And it's going to be Mia. She's going to be doing okay. And we are getting out of here.
Mia. Oh, thank God I found you. It's me. It's Ethan.
Ethan? Ethan?
Are you all right?
You shouldn't be here.
What do you mean? You contacted me.
No. No, I wouldn't. Did I? Did anyone see you? Did he see you?
Hey, who else is here? What the hell's going on?
Daddy's coming. We need to go.
Daddy?
We need to go now!
Oh, it actually is her. And she's not a zombie or anything. I mean, okay, that's actually surprising.
Where are you taking me?
Someplace safe.
Are you gonna tell me what's going on? Baby, you've been gone 3 years.
3 years? Has it really been 3 years?
I can't seem to walk by her.
What is this place? What'd they do to you?
Not now. We need to get out of here first. I think it's this way.
I still can't really walk past her. is preventing me from doing that.
Hmm? Mia, we have to talk. That message you sent me.
Not me. That wasn't me.
But you did.
I didn't.
Okay, fine.
Oh, I'm supposed to be standing here.
What's going on?
I'm telling you everything that I know. We have to go this way.
Mia, are you sure you know where you're going?
Family used to bring me food through here. I remember.
All right, so there was a door here before, but I guess it's gone now, so we can advance.
There. It's there. This is it. I remember this room. There's another door here. I'm sure of it.
Well, let's have a look around.
It's not here. It's gone. It's gone.
Oh, found something. EU.
Oh, we're going to be a family now that you're here.
Oh, great. It's nice to belong.
I'm sure of it.
Hey, it's a Mia doll. It's a one of a kind. I guess I should take the time to make sure that I've seen everything here. These dolls get a lot of RPMs. Doesn't seem like there's anything else here. All right, let's go. What af- apparently... after whatever it was that smashed through that door and took Mia away, I guess is what happened. Looks like that we're heading out of the basement now. Oh, that's friendly. This family seems like it's gotten a bad rap. I mean, they seem like they've been very welcoming so far. Well, I mean, at least we got some kind of sound. It is connected, even if we weren't getting a dial tone. Oh, we got a map. Let's see. Is it for this place? I guess it is. We're in the guest house. If it's the guest house, that does indicate that there is a larger main house somewhere, and I guess that's not where we are. Ooh, first aid med. Not a first aid spray, but good enough. They're more like health drinks. Yeah. No, I'm almost done in here. You're gonna have to wait your turn. Alright, sounds like someone's real impatient. Well, I can't open this. Not sure where the sound is coming from, though. I guess this direction. Guess I'll follow it, since that door was locked. Are we going back down here? It's slowing me down. Mia's been working out. Left click to resist. I don't know if I just didn't resist hard enough.
Yeah. Wait. Wait!
I don't know if I have to click anything. It just seems like this is doing it on its own.
I can hear her. I can feel her clawing her way back inside of me. Get out! Leave me alone! I've been bad. I deserve this.
Mia, we all have our own problems. I mean, none of us are perfect. But you can't say that you deserve the bad things that's been happening to you. After all, you have to be the one that looks out for you. No one else is gonna do it. She makes a convincing argument. Oh, there's the axe.
You shouldn't have come, Ethan. Now you have been dead too.
I'm left clicking a lot, but I'm not sure how much of this is scripted and how much of this is actually combat. Getting this out of the way right away at the beginning of the game, not spending the entire game looking for our wife that we're gonna have to kill at the end. Nope, we're just gonna do it right at the beginning. Oh, got a phone call. Hello?
You really shouldn't have come here.
You're not kidding.
Then what the fuck is going on?
My name's Zoe. There should be a way out through the attic.
Attic.
Go there. Now.
Well, Zoe just seems to know what's going on. Maybe there's surveillance cameras through the house. Zoe's been watching us through them. Oh, let me get my axe. I probably will need that. Oh. Yeah, she's not here. All right, well, I guess we're going to see her again at some point. And there's a lot of blood around the sides of the screen. I probably should use, like, one of these, right? Nope, not like that. Like, there we go. That's how you use that. All right, and we're okay. Don't think there's anything in this room. It did say to go to the attic. Okay, this is open now. So let's see. If they want us to go to the attic, to do that, we need the fuse. And we never found that. The videotape is one thing that we have not used. Let me go back in here. Anything in here? No. That's where the fuse was in the demo. All right, so I guess the videotape is the one thing we haven't tried yet, so I'm gonna give it a try. This might be the same one as in the demo. It's looking like it so far.
Where did you find this guy? Give me a break, Pete.
Alright, we know what's going on here. We know what's gonna happen.
Speaking of which, make sure the sound is right this time. I don't want a repeat of Amarillo.
That was 2 fucking years ago.
I don't do ADR.
All right, you guys, hurry it up. You're going to argue about this house and where we are and how I'm not very good at my job.
Surprised if we have to make a change. New plan.
And the host doesn't like doing this job. He doesn't like being on the show. He feels like he's better than this. We've seen this a bunch of times.
No problem. Tonight on Sewer Gators, another worthless fucking shithole. Happy? Ecstatic.
And I can't open this door until they kick it open for me. All right, I'm going to do my job as a cameraman. I'm going to get these dramatic angles. Yeah, that's right. Look at this.
Are we rolling?
Getting this ominous...
All right, let's go.
Camp angle from below as he tries to open the door. Zoom in right on that doorknob as he can't get it open. All right, I got the angle. Dude, yeah, there you go. Right there. And then we zoom in and we say, oh, what could be waiting in here? Our heroes will find out as they walk slowly down the hallway.
What's the prep, shitty house?
Shining the flashlight wherever the light will catch, wondering what dangers... What threats
I was an anchor, you know?
Might wait for them inside the Dulvey haunted house.
Nothing.
Yeah, we got it good. This is good.
Abandoned farmhouse, missing family, foul play suspected. The usual.
I'm gonna get right behind his shoulder and like stay there. So it's like so it'll be like it is a third person Resident Evil game. And he's the main character right there. I'm gonna get him right in the shot.
Not hillbillies, the Bakers. Jack and Marguerite Baker. They were quiet, not backward.
Let's see if the lockpick is here. In the demo, the lockpick... No. Lockpick is not there.
Ah, shit! I know I should have worn my good shoes.
We're able to find the lockpick in the demo. Right here.
I had my shots.
So we were then able to unlock
this will make a great backdrop.
The drawer.
Andre, what do you think?
Right here. I can't do it though. Andre? Oh, what am I carrying? I have something.
Andre.
Planning document belonging to the amateur video production team Sewer Gators. Ghosts sighted in Bayou. Anyway.
Unbelievable.
Andre has disappeared.
This is the last time I work with that guy.
It really is.
I mean, producers, they come and go, but a good cameraman like you, Clancy, you stick with me.
Clancy, the fearless cameraman, will go upstairs in the attic where no one is. Or is there? He's going to go in there. I want to see if this door is open.
Did you hear that?
No, that's going to be locked. All right, go in. Like the fearless hero you are.
Andre? Where the fuck is he?
I'm going to get the shot as we get over here. And our hero works his way across the room, eventually finding the switch in the fireplace. Oh, something's caught his eye. He's walking over here. What does he possibly see?
What the hell?
He leans forward out of curiosity, pulling the lever, and the secret door opens.
Are you kidding me? All right, new deal. We find Andre and we go. I mean, fuck this show.
Andre down there? Yep, I see him. I guess this video is going to end how it did in the demo.
What do you see? What is it?
Andre, I just want to sneak past you to the left if I can do that. If you're just going to let me... No, you're not. Someone just got welcomed to the family. Not us this time, but I guess Clancy did. All right, so now that we've done that...
Jesus.
Our character has a reaction to that this time. All right, so I have the axe, and I never opened that drawer, so I guess something else is going to be in there. And it doesn't seem like any... I'm not sure if anything necessarily happened due to us watching that tape. It doesn't seem like anything is different. You know, that basement is big, and I don't really want to assume that we have to go back in there and explore it again, since we already did it once. I wonder if I have to break something with the axe now, since it is something that I have that I did not have before. They want us to go in the attic, but I can't do it without the fuse. Because without the fuse, this switch doesn't work. But clearly the fuse is in a different place than it was in the demo. And if that's the case, it really could be anywhere. Unless it's in here. And I can't open that. Oh, wait. This was locked with a chain. And I do have this. This is something that's different now. Forgot about that. Aha! Got it. Anything different down here this time? No. Does not seem like any... What? Was that something? Guess not. All right, we got the fuse. That means we can put this in the fuse box. We can bring down those stairs. Oh, hey! Are you actually an enemy? Or... No, she's just, she was just something to look at. I mean, we do have this axe. And with this axe, we don't have anything to fear from anyone. What am I doing? I did not put the fuse in. Had my mind on Mia, watching her walk past the door, wondering if she's an actual enemy that we can encounter, or was she just like a scripted event? Nope, not that. This.
Ethan, it's okay. It's okay, it's me. I know you didn't mean to hurt me.
You shouldn't have done that! It fucking hurts!
Well, I guess she got us back. Oh, I guess she wants to get us back even more.
Let's see what you feel.
You don't usually block a chainsaw with your arm. I mean, I guess he didn't have anything else.
Must contain outbreak. Gonna win, I promise. Must burn it all down.
Oh, are we just walking around like nothing's wrong? Because I think we might be going into shock at this point. And I don't think one of these is... Well, maybe should we use it? I don't know if our health is going down, because like there's only a little bit of blood on the screen, though we are holding up our severed stump. Can we pick up our hand? Okay, we can. What does it say about our hand? It's our left hand. It's still warm. I mean, maybe we can find a way to put it back on. But, you know, first things first, we have to think about pressing this button so we can go up the stairs. Ethan is... He has a one-track mind, and that can be a strength. He could... Oh, let me save. He could ignore that his hand was just cut off, and just, you know... Oops. And just keep on trucking. It's admirable, really. You know, I'm not sure how scary the scripted segments are. Like that whole thing with the screwdriver and the chainsaw, I just want to point out that I had no interaction there. And if that's the case, then there's no way I could fail. And if there's no way I could fail, how scary could it be? But that's just me being critical.
Okay, fine.
Sounds like Ethan's had enough. Seven and five bullets, so 12 in total. Seven loaded, five extra. It's not many, and kind of hard to tell how many would actually take to take down Mia. Doesn't look like Ethan is thinking about trying to save Mia anymore, or trying to rescue her from whatever her plight is. He's just like, okay, fine, let's do this. Alright, I'm picking up a bunch of ammo. I wonder if I should use it, or... Oh, I can still use the axe. I can one-hand my axe. You know, I heard that ammo was really scarce in this game, so I'm wondering... Should I use the gun? Because it kind of seems like it's setting me up that I'm going to want to use the gun pretty... Yeah, look at all this ammo! How much do I have? 7 and 32... Maybe I'll have to use it. I don't know. But considering how rare ammo was supposed to be in this, and considering how much ammo they're giving me right now, I'm kind of wondering, should I use it when we encounter whatever it is that we're going to encounter? Or should I just try to use the axe? Alright, the last time I played the demo, that's where it ended. And this seems to be the path that the house is leading me to. So I guess let's find out what happens this time. Is that a chainsaw? Ah, yeah.
I have to do this!
Yep, I guess I'm gonna have to use the gun after all. Because chainsaw is a pretty... It's a little better than a hatchet. And I just pour that on my stump. Feels so much better. How did she get up to that window? She moves pretty quickly. I'm assuming headshots are what we need to do. Got too close. And this is a Resident Evil game, and a video game in general, so headshots do seem like what... Oh, hey. I love you too, honey. This is just our Saturday night thing, is all. And I can't pick up the chainsaw. Are you really not going to let me pick up that chainsaw? I can kick the chainsaw. I can play soccer with the chainsaw. I really think that for winning this boss battle, you should just let me take that chainsaw.
Welcome to the family, son.
Of course. I'm glad that was in the full game. You know it was going to happen at some point. And you know... That's probably... Okay, and there is an achievement that's called that. You know, that's probably enough for this first part of Bumbling through Resident Evil 7. It was a sufficient bumble. And we got through, I guess, the first section of the game. They were...
Come on. Don't you die on us now. You have work to do.
Looks like it's just taking us into a next section automatically, though. And is our hand back on? Looked like we had our hand back.
What the hell?
Rise and shine, sleepyhead. It's time for supper.
Who are all you people? Where's Mia?
Eat it. It's good.
Dumb son of a bitch wasn't no good if it hit him.
Lucas!
Not again!
Get out the way, Margaret.
Hit boy's got to eat. He got to have his supper. Come here, boy. Let's do this.
Oh shit, he's not eating it, Jack! He's not eating
it! Get the hell up, Marguerite!
I'll pay that for him!
Get the hell out of here!
You're a son of a bitch! Oh, I can't believe it, you son of a bitch! He's not eating it! He's not eating it!
This was supposed to be a very special feast. Come on, boy. Bet it's that cop again.
Goddamn pigs. I'm coming back for you.
That's a pretty good scene. That's all right. I like how the developers know that more than zombies and more than monsters, the scariest thing is being forced to eat disgusting food. That's not a scare that you see in video games very often. Here, eat this thing. No, eat it. You have to eat the thing. Look, Grandma's not eating. I don't see why I have to. I guess that one's locked. Oh, lost all my items. Let me take a look at that. Yeah. Items are gone, and I'm wearing a watch? That has my vitals on it, I guess, and my hands back. Maybe I could break it with something, but I lost all my breaking tools. Do we want to go into the garage? I think we could remove that tape. You're not convincing me that it could not be removed by hand. It seems plenty removable. They said that there was probably a cop at the door, so I guess even though they live at them in the middle of nowhere, it's not quite enough in the middle of nowhere that they're not going to get visits by the cops. Is there someone out there? It's like there's a light, but I can't see where it's coming from. Hey, what's going on?
Thought you'd just slip out before dinner was done.
Hey, I thought we were all part of the family now. Is this how you treat your family? I mean, fine. But look, I'm not here to judge how you raise your family. I just feel like this maybe is a bit of an overreaction. Oh, not sure what I picked up right there.
Boy, you are nothing. Just a man without a...
They're pretty strict when it comes to their table manners in this family. That seems a bit too much. I don't know. I mean, I know that teaching your children respect for the rules, respect for other people, and respect for the family, I know this is all important. I mean, getting up in the middle of dinner doesn't seem like it warrants this. But I guess that's actually where we're now going to stop Resident Evil 7. So that's it for part one, and we'll continue on with part two as old Ethan, up to no good, he's all naughty, and he's gonna try to slip out in the middle of dinner, sneak out away from the dinner table that Ma spent so much time and effort cooking up for him. She did it for him, and we're not going to even eat a single bite. Can you believe that? Well, I guess that's what we're doing next time, as we're going to join the family back at the table, as apparently we get interrupted by the cops, is what I guess what happened there. And then I guess we'll see where this goes. I'm not really sure where this is going, or how much of a connection this is going to have with any other Resident Evil game, but I'm liking what I'm seeing so far. We'll continue on next time. And now we know not to get Dad's attention after we sneak away from the table, because he will be peeved. He'll be miffed, is what you call that. I'll see you next time.